I know this one is difficult, but the fact that he is a man of virtue and simplicity, I feel elated to introduce him. If one takes a closer look at the alchemy of Mr. Paritkar, two distinct virtues pop up. Besides perseverance and hard work, these are pioneer spirit and willingness to strive. He was appointed as Director Corporate HR at Poonawalla Group in October 2012, prior to which he worked in DMCFS designated as Chief Executive Officer in Cummins Generator Technologies India as DGM HR and also in Cadbury as a human resource professional for 20 years. He completed his post-graduation from the College Institute of Business Management and Research, Chinchwad, Pune, and his graduation from Nauroji College, Pune. I can go on talking about the feathers in his hat, but it would be probably in your best interest if you hear it out from the man himself. We welcome you, sir.
Good evening. Yeah, thank you so much. This has been a very pleasant evening. I'm very happy to be in amidst so many young professionals. My topic pertains to emerging business challenges. For information, I have worked with very good companies. I'm fortunate to do that. I worked with Cadbury's, which happens to be a very sweet company, and most of them would like to have it. 20 years with this company, and then got a good connect with the value systems, the way they work, they expect, and they deliver. I have been connecting with people who have been working there as workmen who were taken from the rural areas. They were groomed to produce the international product. I think the training and grooming all started there. And as we move further, I worked later on with Cummins Generator Technologies, which is an engineering company. And further to that, then I'm connected with Poonawalla Engineering Group. We manufacture actuators, different types of valves. We call them gate, globe, and check valves, and also the butterfly valves. These are basically used in every sector, wherever there is a pipeline. You have to control it, and valve is one of the major product which impacts the flow systems. So we are connected in India and domestic as well as international market. So I'm sure there are students who are sitting in the international business and also from the marketing and also from human resources. Though I'm connected with human resources, definitely the best part of it is that I'm connected with human beings and the talent pool. And therefore, I'm connected with each and every sector. And whatever I'm going to speak has not only the influence of human resources, but also on human talent. So connecting with this emerging challenges, what I would definitely like to say is, we have been definitely going through a very difficult stage as of now. Difficult stage has always been there. No business thrives without difficult situations. But the situation is a bit larger this time. And when I talk of emerging challenges, I would definitely connect with the talent aspect more because I belong to that domain. So in terms of a broader perspective, so when I speak of business, I'm connecting with the manufacturing industry and the phase that we are going into. So this phase, basically, we are falling short of orders in terms of because of the overall slowdown in the market. So there has been a very competitive business trend which is going on. What do I mean by a very competitive business trend? When the markets are low and slow, then there are so many competitors who would like to get that order with the best price, the best delivery options, and this really impacts. So it actually strains all the systems within the company when one tries to get an order. It impacts the manufacturing process, the delivery time, it gets strained. If there is a competitor who is willing to give a product, say within 12 weeks, Then there's some competitor who says, no, I can deliver it in 10 weeks. Then there's someone who says, no, I can deliver it within 5 weeks. So it becomes a very strenuous activity at the shop floor. Not only that, it impacts the cost also. So delivering in time at a very respectable price, it puts a lot of strain on all the systems. And this happens with every industry, and I think we are going through that type of phase. So what happens is, competition basically is not only for the company, but also for the people who work within. When I talk of this, I mean that every professional, therefore, has to put in an extra effort. Every skill that has been judged till now will have to do something extra. Every competition will bring in some more qualities in a person. More competition in terms of developing the talent also is a strain on the human resources. So getting the right people in this competition, what I see, most of the companies would like to get or headhunt a person who has been doing well in some other company. So again, retaining a talent becomes a challenge. So we have been definitely going into this type of scenario just now. And this competition is not only about the business, but also every aspect that connects with business. So this stiff competition, what I told you, is impacting every industry. Like suppose we are in valve industry, we have many players who have been working on this ground. And similar such aspects are getting tougher each day. It does not mean that these are the frightening aspects for the young professionals. I have not come here to basically disturb your continuity. I'm here to tell you that when tough times are going on, we also have different methods to solve these problems. And we also need creative brains to work on these aspects and definitely come out of this situation. So people management, as I told you, happens to be a very common phenomena. In human resources, we have been tackling this problem of getting the right resource for the right slot. Recently, we have recruited one international business head who comes from a very large company. And then we have been exploring aspects connected with expertise in that domain. So the right type of people in the quality department, the right of people in the supply chain, all these people will really have to make a good impact to the system. In our company, this trend is now a very common and is also a concern area. So when we talk of only the heads and the leadership, I'm also talking about the people who are placed in the middle management, also the workers, and also the people who are helping the system. So when I talk of people management, taking care of their expectations is also a big issue. So this challenge has to be tackled in a very sensitive manner, because we have to retain certain people. There are people who are not required in the system because of the specialties that might not be correct to the system. We have to identify that. We have several systems like skill matrix exercises, which help the people to get the right insight and then work on that. So I have been receiving students from BIMM and also this other reputed institutions who have really made a good change in 2 months' time. So I appreciate whatever systems that you have developed, whatever academics you have been thought of, and those you could relate to these systems. I had a few students for our operations and also for international sales and also. Then focus on leadership. So when tough times are on, I think most of the eyes will definitely turn towards the leadership. What type of strategies are important now? What type of proactive measures will have to be taken? Which are the things which will have to be stopped? And which are the things which have to be gaining some momentum? So leadership, decisions, and the consensus is very important. So we have to keep an eye on the competition, and this basically puts us into a different scenario altogether. Market connect on a domestic scale and on international scale, it definitely impacts the way we operate. Business scenarios change with the way that even competitions are changing. So expectations, like everyone expects something. Even the customers expect different things every time. as technology changes, even the product range changes, and the development does not change to that extent. So it puts additional pressure on the system. The people who are engaged in the design development stages, they have to put in some extra effort. Then the people who develop product or manufacture them, they also are into stress because they have to produce that product in a given time. And the delivery matters, basically the customers who are asking for such products in a very short time. So all these pressures are definitely the emerging challenges. I'm talking of emerging challenges, therefore you will feel that I am sounding negative. No, I'm not. Challenges are never negative. They are opportunities. And definitely, when we talk of opportunities, we definitely put the system in stress. We challenge our own system, our own learning and thinking also. So basically, unleashing the talent happens to be one of the major focus areas as of now. The people who are experienced in a certain manner, they have to give a very good change for themselves. The paradigm change has to be noticed. And this happens with a lot of training and development which takes place. These people are also vulnerable in terms of they are attracted by competition. Whenever a new person joins, he or she definitely would like to get into some different domain. Person now is not having that mentality of staying with the company for long. 2-3 years of experience and they feel that they have done enough and they start moving out. I think every company expects a person to be here to develop the company and also develop his or her own career. And I think that makes the change in the unleashing the talent. Even in the HOD positions, the department head positions, I think we are definitely taking some big challenges of recruiting the right people. Because these people are not, though there is a lot of unemployment in the market, but getting the right people has become a very strenuous effort now. So when we talk of overcoming the challenges, basically employee engagement, this has been a very commonly used phenomena, but the style of engagement of people has been changing over a period of time. During the emerging challenges, I think employee engagement in terms of challenging their talent has become important. So most of the people, those who are talented, would leave a job if they are not challenged. This has been a very common phenomenon. They expect that they need to be challenged, that their skills need to be challenged, and the talent needs to be challenged. If they are put in such a department or a portfolio which does not even challenge their aspects which they have learned, then they feel this is not a good company to work for. Therefore, even the pressures are not only from the market, but also from within the system and within the talent systems. So we have to take care of these people. Therefore, retaining such talent is important. Engagement in terms of whatever a person has done in the past, the same thing cannot be expected now. With the emerging challenges, with the emerging expectations, I think every individual who is engaged as a professional, as an officer or a manager, he is expected to do something better than what he has been doing in the earlier. Because normally in companies, people expect higher salaries every time. But with the same skill sets and the same output, I think companies cannot afford to give the same salaries or the increments in that process. So what change one has to bring in oneself? That is an aspect which is putting a lot of stress. Even for individuals. So people motivation. So in this scenario, when the things are not working in your favor, people motivation is a big challenge. That is a challenge in terms of what can make this person live or come to work in a happy mood manner, and how can he deliver his best. So this employee motivation, a lot of companies are putting different initiatives. Apart from money, definitely money is only one factor, but there are so many other things which definitely motivate an individual. So people motivation in terms of giving them a better work, making them involved into cross-functional projects, then developing some new initiatives which challenge their motivation. All these things are happening in the industry. So people motivation continues to be one of the important factors to bring a company out of this difficult scenario. So basically preparedness for future. In terms of preparedness, so when the technology itself is changing, even the customers are demanding different things. Now, if they demand one thing in the current scenario, immediately within the same purchase order or the same model, they will ask something different tomorrow. So this dynamism has to be brought into workplace immediately. If the system is not ready for a change, then competition definitely actually kills the aspect, and then they win a different order. So connecting with the customers, connecting with their expectations is one aspect of the industry. So connecting means what? Basically understanding proactively before they could really come up with some suggestions. We have to understand and see that the system is ready in terms of certification, in terms of, I believe some students are there from international business. So even in international business, we have to get approvals from different companies which are not connected with the organ industry. Then there are different certifications which are connected with every aspect in terms of standards. So basically the system has to be ready in terms of having those standards implemented into the company. So this is a different challenge. So continuing with the current challenges and also foreseeing that there are few new challenges which are coming up. The company gets into such systems and the people have to be ready for that. If the current manpower is bogged down because of the current routine aspects, then where's the chance of getting into the new areas which the company is expecting? Therefore, these issues are definitely on the forefront, and we have been taking a lot of initiatives to develop new standards, new ways of working, new people who would think differently. There are people who would be doing some routine jobs. There are people who are engaged into strategic new alignments, new certifications, new ways of working and processes. So all these things have to work in harmony. We just cannot rely on one aspect and wait for something else to happen. Otherwise, in the meantime, there is competition who is challenging us in different ways. Sharpening the skills. For every individual, this aspect is very important. Sharpening the skills in terms of whatever they have learned, the new skills and the new technologies. This sharpening of skill basically also means new ways of working, new methodologies. We have been promoting people in terms of giving some kaizens or the new ideas which will put the system in a very smooth manner. So sharpening of skills will happen due to a lot of training, a lot of hand-holding, and helping them to do something new. Improving the business processes. Improving the business processes basically means that we are connected with different supply chain management, then quality assurance aspects. All these things are important, that they need to be changed and seen in a different manner. Because whatever has been worked till now is not relevant in the current scenario. It has to be challenged, and the newcomers are expected to basically challenge the status quo and then do something different. So whenever we get some interns in our company, we give them different projects in terms of looking at that same problem in a different way, and we are definitely getting some good results. So improving the business processes also helps in improving the decision-making processes. Decision-making in terms of strategy, in terms of people management, in terms of different certifications. I think improving the business process has itself been a very important challenge which the companies are facing now. Training and development continues to be one of the important criteria for getting us prepared for the future. So a lot of training programs are basically put into the training calendar in terms of understanding what is required in the system. So each and every individual in the system is asked for what is required, and the person is assessed by the HOD, and then that is put into the training calendar. So this training calendar connects with the commercial aspects, the new changes that are happening in the government, the new taxation, the new technologies, and also some commercial aspects which are connected with the system. then there are not many certifications which are always undergoing some change. So training is also connected with that. So these training programs are delivered within the system and also from external agencies. And when we talk of training programs, they also connect with some managerial skills which are essential for us to grow to the next level. So as you also are learning into these areas, we also conduct certain exercises in the company which are connected with the managerial skill development. The most prominent which I feel has been communication skills, and this is triggering some other development areas. So apart from that, managerial skills and the young talent development also happens to be one major area. So we have been recruiting a lot of interns in every department, and we expect them to learn a good number of things, and within 1 year's time, I think they pick up very well, and that has to be one of the important factors for most of them are engaged actually. A lot of them have got permanent employment. So I think that's a good factor. Normally in graduate traineeship program, these people complete their 1 year and then they have to move out. But most of the students who have picked up are really absorbed by my company, and which happens to be a very good factor. Otherwise, in the era of unemployment, I think we are making good change in the other direction. We are challenging them, we are helping them, we are handholding, supporting them. Even the onboarding exercise is perfect in terms of making the person comfortable and do something unique. Even the systems, the IT, the reports, the MIS, everything has changed. With the change scenario, with the new people coming from good companies, these people are bringing in new thoughts and new ideas, and these are helping us in the decision making process. All these aspects are very important in terms of dealing with the challenges that we are facing. So I was talking to you not on a very international scale, neither on a national scale basically. I was trying to translate what is actually happening in the manufacturing company, because I have worked with food factories, also with some engineering companies, and I know that this constitutes the manufacturing process and what type of challenges are there. I can witness them definitely. So instead of talking big things, I'm talking to you small things which are impacting the market, and what as an individual you are supposed to do, or I am supposed to do. That is the thing which is going to help us. Big talk with no action is not going to help, is what my perfect thinking is. A small opportunity, when clicked and given the right channel, I think makes a difference. And we as a company have been actually working towards that. So there have been challenging times, even now there are challenging times, but that challenging times are definitely putting some good pressures to do some good work. Otherwise, that gets left out in routine processes. I think we are happy that we are into a challenging position, because at least some out-of-the-box thinking will happen. And this is necessary in everyone's life. As stated in my own career, I've told you that I was comfortable with a very good company. But when I realized that I was getting comfortable, that is the time I changed my scenario. I wanted to get out of it, because that comfort is really going to kill your innovation and also the growth pattern. So I think the phase that we are into, instead of getting threatened or frightened of that, we can challenge ourselves, we can challenge our abilities, we can learn more, do better, and be ready for the change. I think with a positive note, if we see this challenge, I think nothing is very difficult in life. As an individual, as good professionals, as a young professionals, though you are seeing these things happening, so these things are definitely going to trigger some different thoughts and ideas and innovation into your head. And that is what is required by the industry. I have been delivering lectures to various youth in different colleges and helping them to think differently. I think when situations are different, you can still be better, because the same model will not apply now. Challenges are there, difficulties will be there. So without challenge and difficulty, I don't think anything will change. But let us not look at that aspect into a negative thing. We are doing a positive change, and we will do a positive change. Technologies have erased some products, no problem. But we are developing some new products which are required by the new technology. So we are getting ready for the future. I think getting ready for the future is also one of the aspects you are into now. because you will be the next generation who will be managing such companies with such a volatile business, the different changing environment. So no issues. You will be equipped to handle such situations. Every situation has its own way of working. Earlier days also, there were difficult times, but the people have managed that. And we are now seeing a growth pattern. Then there's a downturn. So no issues at all. It's only the attitude which is going to matter. And I think if we have the right thing in mind and the right channel to operate, we'll definitely make a big change. With the given time, I have only these points, but definitely I would like to receive some questions and then answer them and make it more interactive rather than speaking on each of the aspects on a different note.
Very good evening, sir. My name is Karanveer. I'm from the first year batch of marketing. Sir, my question to you is, in our principles and practices of management, we have got up about how manufacturing industries work, about time and motion study we have been taught. So just relating to that, sir, since you were giving an example, like, you know, if there is a valve or something that you're manufacturing, your competition is ready to deliver it in the lesser period of time. But then again, sir, you have a limited workforce, you cannot even extend them. So, sir, have you ever, reached a stage or any situation that you could share? Like, you know, when people have not been ready to work under you, because very recent examples I can give you, like State Bank, when it was going for a merger, people were on strike. Again, you know, the similar case with Bank of Baroda and other banks as well. So have people ever revolted to you saying that, you know, we cannot deliver this thing in a, you know, in a time which is lesser than what it used to be?
See, I think it depends on the culture of the company. If the team is motivated and they know they can do it, they have put their heart and soul inside and done the things. When it comes to people and delivery, I think we are doing a very good job. But it's not that factor. The factor is that we have to get the castings on time. We have to get the right model on right time. So all this flow management, supply chain management, if it is not perfect and the people are ready, then we again have a problem. So that is one aspect which I have very clearly known. They have been doing overtime, they are working on Sundays, they would like to work on holidays, but they would like to produce. So that is the people aspect. Because they know that this is the thing that is going to govern their future. But only thing is the supply chain and how we manage that supply chain becomes important. If the casting is not arriving on time, what will the worker do? So we have to manage certain other areas. The other key areas are important. This area we can fix because we can talk to them, because they belong to the same company. If they deliver, they will flourish. If they don't, they will not. That equation is very clear. So I think it's not only about people. If there are certain factors, we resolve it. We have some processes within the company to resolve some grievances. And then we have some internal committees which work towards that. We have some definite good leadership which takes care of that on the shop floor. It does not say that we don't have problems. We will have problems. But when it comes to delivery, I think it's the winning thing is that we have to deliver. Otherwise, we'll be at loss, because that is the position which normally a competitor would like to grab.
Good evening, everyone. I would like to thank Mr. Pravin Paritkar for sharing his valuable time with us. Sir spoke about human talent, employee engagement, and improving the business processes. Ladies and gentlemen, I, Ankush Paul, sincerely urge you to continue the spirit of learning at every stage of your career and life, because an investment in knowledge and learning gives you the best interest. Thank you.